overcome the darkness. He had reached the mountain. He could finally find his sister. Reached the summit, Olle felt regret. Not stop his sister from being taken. Not stop the woman from drowning her child. He had reached the end that Tuva had pointed him towards. Now, entering the halls of the mountain, Olle was ready to find his sister. Exhausted, bloody, and at his wit's end, King Nils came to a witch's house on the outskirts of his kingdom. He fell to his knees, begging the witch to help cure his son, and she agreed. The witch explained that the flower held tremendous power that could only very carefully be used for good. The witch instructed he only use a single petal. Using the whole bloom would only invite death. Began to recover, but discontent at the royal line had grown in the kingdom following King Nils' bloody campaign. The next day, King Nils found his son dead, and the last light holding his darkness at bay was snuffed out. Heartbroken, King Nils turned to the bloom which had promised life, and instead saw it as an escape from his suffering. The witch, having come to visit the king and the prince, looked at the nightmarish scene in despair. She raised a mountain on top of King Nils and shackled him using the same bramble that he let loose upon the kingdom. To this day, the trolls still feed him as punishment. Mountain King, who was meant to be hidden forever, was now revealed. He just had to reach the sack before Lilimur ended up as the giant's dinner.
Thank you.
bramble weakened. The Mountain King saw clearly for the first time in centuries. And what he saw reminded him of his beloved son. He would not lose him again. This time, King Nils would overcome the darkness. Tuva had one last gift to give to Olle. A nightmare woke her up. frightened by her memories. She searched for her brother's comfort. But he was nowhere to be found. However, the darkness outside did not scare her. Because she knew she had her brother.